But you know what, when they ask that question, there's a lot of, there's going to be a lot of things that can affect how you respond. Because in this journey of life, a lot of things can happen from the time you're born to the time you die. You can face unemployment, illness, discrimination, a lot of things. And will you still be faithful? Will you still have that fire inside of you to keep you going? So the man who has received the one talent came. And the master, he said, I knew that you were a hard man, harvesting when you had not sown, and gathering when you had not scattered seed. So I was afraid. And went out and hid your talent in the ground. See, here's what belongs to you. His master recites, you wicked, lazy servant. So you knew that I harvest where I had not sown, and gathered where I had not scattered seed. Well then, you should have put your money on deposit with the banker so that when I return, I would have received it with interest. Isn't that interesting? Sometimes some people small you could do, but some people are not even willing to do that. So he says, take the talent from him and give it to the one who has the 10 talents. For everyone who has will be given more, and he will have an abundance. Whoever does not have, even what he has will be given from his saving from him. And throw that worthless burden outside into the darkness, where there will be weeping and gnashing of teeth. So tonight, I want to concentrate on the servant, the one that has the one talent. Five possible reasons for this servant to miss the chance. Porque mi interesa. Because Mama Inesa is grateful to come to the church, and I want to make sure that she's here for something. So aquí estaba yo hablando de los personas, y cada uno multiplicó lo que no se dio. Pero el último no hizo eso. Y entonces Dios habló con él sobre las consecuencias de que iba a pasar por él. So, esta noche en mi mensaje me voy a concentrar en la persona que no multiplicó la moneda que Dios le dio. Y esta noche voy a hablar de cinco razones por las cuales él se fue, él perdió la oportunidad. Porque esta noche voy a hablar de perder, por qué perdemos la oportunidad. La primera, the first one being laziness. Sometimes we're lazy. La primera razón por qué perdemos la oportunidad a veces es pereza. Somos flojos. Y quiero leer este versículo de la Biblia que está en Proverbios, capítulo 10, 4. And it says, lazy hands make a man poor, but diligent hands bring wealth. Quiero leer en el libro de Proverbios, capítulo 10, versículo 4, algo que nos habla de la pereza. Las manos ociosas conducen a la pobreza. Las manos hábiles atraen riqueza. And in Ecclesiastes chapter 10, verse 18, it says, if a man is lazy, the rafters sag. If his hands are idle, the house leaks. Y en Ecclesiastes capítulo 10, versículo 18, dice, por causa del ocio se viene abajo el techo, y por la pereza se desploma la casa. So basically, he was lazy. The guy that only was here in the house, he was lazy. He couldn't even think to put his money in the bank where it would work itself. And he would work out with a dollar and 5 cents instead of just a dollar. Okay. So basically, he was lazy, and that's a problem that could affect all of us. Okay, so the second reason tonight that I'm concentrating on this person here is that sometimes laziness makes us take shortcuts. can be valuable, because I'm a person that I'm very efficient, and I like to always do things very efficiently. That's just the way I was raised, that's part of my DNA. And I remember when the digital camera was invented, and you no longer have to buy a roll of film, take the picture, take all the pictures to get developed. You don't have to do it anymore. You could just buy that little chip and then take the picture that you want. Take the chip, go to your computer or go to Costco and take the best picture from the one you didn't want, you deleted them. I thought, wow, isn't that a great invention? All the money you're saving. All you gotta do is buy that little chip. Or the microwave. Isn't that another great invention? You're hungry, you get your food, you put it in the microwave, the turkey comes out. Or email. Isn't that great? You want to send somebody some information, and you send it, and they have it 2 minutes in Mexico. So there's some things about shortcuts, but let me give you just a quick example. There was a man that lived in the mountains, and he was with his wife, and they were inside the living room, and they were sitting by a fireplace, and they heard the rain, and they wanted to go outside to get more wood. So the woman tells the man, can you go outside and see if it's still raining? And he says, why don't we call the dog in? And he comes in and he's wet, we'll know that it's raining. Because he didn't want to get up if it was still raining. Okay? So you know, there's little things like that that sometimes say why we're, you know, there's laziness. And the second reason for the talent, the lack of the motivation for him to have talent, could be wickedness. Because sometimes man is weak. You know, sometimes you want to do things, you want the shortcut. And an example that I found that was very interesting was there was a shoemaker, and he was making shoes. And I don't know if you're familiar with making shoes, but you have to cut the sole of the shoe, and then you have to wet it, and then you have to hit it really hard, and, you know, it's a process, but those are the best shoes that are made. So this man, he gets the shoe, and he wets it, and then he starts putting it back on the shoe quicker. And this other guy is watching him, and he says, why are you doing that? And he says, it will come back faster. You know, and how many times don't general contractors do that? Where they don't put the roof on right so they can leave? You know, where somebody does something so that you can have repeat business. Somebody, you know, goes to Nordstrom, buy the blouse, they want to wear it one day and then return it. There's just people that already have that in their mind. So let me talk to you a little bit about wickedness. In Proverbs 5:21, verse 21-22, it talks about wickedness. And it says, for a man's ways are in the full view of the Lord. So you know, sometimes nobody's watching us. But doing the right thing is doing the right thing and nobody's watching. So for a man's ways are in the full view of the Lord, and he examines all his paths. The evil deeds of a wicked man ensnare him. The cords of his sins hold him fast. And in chapter 12, verse 3, it says, a man cannot be established through wickedness, but the righteous cannot be uprooted. And I want to also read this other scripture, which I really love. In Ecclesiastes chapter 7, verse 15, in his meaningless life of mine, I have seen both of these. A righteous man perishing in his righteousness, and a wicked man living long in his wickedness. Y la segunda razón sería la maldad. Y lo más quiero leer este versículo que creo que es muy importante, y se encuentra en el libro de Ecclesiastes, capítulo 7, versículo 15. Y dice, todo esto lo hizo durante mi absurda vida. Hombres justos adquieren su justicia, los destruyen y hombres malos. su maldad les haga.